Welcome to the Country Scroller. In today's video, we're going to be making this welcome key holder.
This welcome key holder will help you organize your keys so you won't lose them.
Also, like your garage door opener, like you see here.
Let's get started.
Alright, to start this welcome key holder sign, you start with a pattern. This is by Steve Good, and it says welcome to our home, but we're not going to use that part. We're just going to use this welcome part here that has the cool lettering to it. Not even any of the flowering stuff underneath, so I can just go ahead and cut that away now and only use the bottom part where it has the letters. So if that gives you an idea right there, we're just going to use the letters and then put it onto the board, cut out that part, and then have the whole thing like you saw just a little bit ago when it was done. So we'll just be using that part for the actual letter part of it. The wood that we're going to be using is some leftover poplar that I had, and this is from Okooch. I recognize that place in the past couple videos good place to get scroll saw ready hardwood, and in this case this is a soft wood, but you can get different exotics or domestic woods there, and at reasonable cost too. So look those people up at Okooch Hardwoods, and some good quality wood. So I'll go ahead and put the pattern on this and then get it all situated and show you how to make it. Alright, so that's the pattern on the wood, and I just drew the general shape of what it'll look like on the bottom, and it's just going to, you know, extend from the bottom of the letters, and that'll all be a solid area for the dowels to go in to hold the keys and whatever that'll hang on this. So I'll go ahead and go over to the scroll saw and start cutting this out. Alright, let's start cutting. I have a number one ultra reverse tooth blade in there, by the way. Alright, so that's what it looks like so far. And now I'm going to go ahead and sand it good on the face there before I have the dowels in there, because it'd be hard to sand with the dowels in. Alright, for this we're going to be using a 5/16 dowel, and this happens to be poplar. That's why I originally went with poplar for this whole thing. And let's go ahead and map these out real quick and just show you where I want to put them at. I only have like two or three things that will really be on here, so I'm just going to put three dowels on here. So at 7 inches, I'll just mark, let's see here, at 1.5, and then 1.5, and then in between there, 2. So I'll just make them there. Now I'll make them at a slight angle, so they'll be angled up. I don't know if you could see that well, but I'll show you what I mean once I drill them. I'll drill them all the way through here too. So I don't know if you can see the angle there. I'll drill the others and then put them in and show you how it'll be. Alright, so I got all three holes drilled now. I'm going to put in the dowels, and I cut them at 1.25 inches. So the 1/4 inch of the actual piece that could go through. And then that gives you a hint of the angle that they'll sit at. And they'll be going in further, and then all of them proud in the back, which means protruding. And I'll just sand them flush. And then the glue I'm going to use is this Turbo Tacky Glue. It's by Aleene's. You've heard of me using that in the past. So I don't need any fancy wood glue for this. It's not like it's any, you know, important joinery or anything like that. So this will be fine. So let's get those glued in. Alright, in the history of the Country Scroller, this is not the first time I identify a flaw that I made. I guess she was too flimsy, and when I was driving in the pegs, it just broke. So, what I'm going to do is I have this cool looking piece of butternut here that's left over from something. And I'm going to glue this whole piece onto that. And it'll be square and cool looking. And then I think that'll look pretty cool actually. So I'm going to go ahead and just cut that piece out and then sand it and glue it to that. Alright, the glue on this welcome sign is dry. And how you can tell is when I put the Turbo Tacky Glue on there, it comes out white, but it dries clear, so that's pretty good. So in case there is a slight bit of squeeze out in those hard to get areas, you don't have to worry about it. So that's one of the advantages of using that type of glue. So now what we can do is just make sure everything's done and sanded, which it is, and then we can put a clear coat on it. I'm just going to use this Rust-Oleum lacquer here. Thanks for watching this video of the welcome key holder slash garage door opener holder, or whatever you can hold on to it. So this is an easy project, a little flaw in the design at the beginning as you saw, and it looks different than what I was planning at the beginning of the video, obviously. But a little minor fix to it by putting on a backer, which looks alright, just made out of a little scrap wood, and doesn't look half bad, and it's useful. So that's today's project. We'll see you next week with another video. Stay tuned at the Country Scroller, and watch the past videos, and you can see our website in the description below. So thanks for watching. I'm Dustin.
And I'm Dylan.
We'll see you next time on the Country Scroller.
Thanks.